guys, party time on call. We are here to work on this thing. It's a cooler. It's been down since 1 o'clock this afternoon, and I just got here. It's 10 minutes after 9, and it's hot. This puppy's hot. Now, supposedly we've quoted just recently replacing some things on this thing. So I'm gonna guesstimate, hopefully, that it's just start components are shot. You got liquid through there, so this puppy's full of liquid, I'm sure now. Yeah, she's hot. She's definitely hot. But they said they could hear it click every time, every now and again, you know, kind of like the compressor ain't starting. I noticed too, the condenser fan's not running, which also is kind of, you know, questionable. I pulled the disconnect there because I didn't want it to keep on trying. Let's see if we can spin this fan blade and get some movement out of it. That spins. That's a good sign. Looks to me like we've got some juiciness there from the start capacitor. Generally speaking, the start relay is toast-o-matic. If you see all this up in here, that looks like capacitor guts. Now, why did the fan not run? It has its own capacitor. Well, hello, do your math. The fan didn't run because the pressure switch didn't energize because we didn't build head pressure. Hello. That's why. Let's see if we can dig that out with get whatever that nasty crap is all over our hands. Went ahead and used the gloves there, and we got a new capacitor in there. I got one that's just maybe 5 to 10 farad over. I think this one here is 124 to 154. This one goes up to 160 something. I don't want to waste the only one I've got, which I don't even know if I've got the exact one, but it's a Copeland. Had the resistor on it. It's brand new. I figured we'll sacrifice that one. That way, if that start relay does stick and blows it up, I might have potentially the exact match. Either way, I'm going to recommend we replace the start relay and start capacitor. The run capacitor there checked out at 39.2. It's rated for 40. Surprisingly, that's fine. We had one wire here that was wire nut fell off. I pulled and tugged on all these and tightened up any of them. So everything should work. Now this wire here only goes to the solenoid. So not, you know, it probably came apart when I moved some of these wires. We're gonna go ahead and kick it on and see what happens. See if we have sparks or if we have compression. High-end breaker box. Sounds like it's running. Fan don't sound. I think it's running. I kind of smell a little something. That fan didn't sound too good. It seemed a little bogged down. I wonder if it went off on thermal. Right now, they could very easily have all that liquid chugging away at it. We may have to. Yeah, it's not running. We're gonna have to valve it off and slowly open up that suction. It's good. Pull out this wonderful death connect. There we go. Let's go ahead and valve this thing off, see if we can open it up slowly. Okay, so we've got it valved off all the way in. That's going to allow it to suck down on the gauge, and hopefully it starts. We'll be able to see if it's pumping at least. Let's see what we get here. Oh, that's a good way to blow that sucker up. There we go. You hear that click, 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 click. That's because the relay is kicking in and out. We're going to have to relieve or equalize that pressure, whatever you want to call it. I'll be right back. Well, I valved that off, like you've seen, and tried to relieve a little bit of the pressure off of it, and it didn't slow down, which really makes me think we might have valves out. That wouldn't be good either. So we may have to valve off the high side there and see if we can relieve or recover the refrigerant out of it and see if the plates are screwed, which is very possible. Not on a good roll right now, to say the least. Okay, kids. So I valved off the high side. Pressure went away pretty quick. Let's open up our high side here. This is going to, if we have bad valves, it's going to come backwards through the head and out the suction side. We are valved in, which means we are backseated, which means you're open to the compressor, but not to the line set. Same thing here. You can unhook this, pull the compressor out. If we open this up, You can bleed from suction to high, but you can't bleed, should not be able to bleed from high to suction. Not good. You've lost the valves. Valves are shot, dude. Yeah, all I can do is pull that head. Went ahead and threw on my headlamp, which is my Phoenix light. So, pop these bolts out. Handy dandy impact there. Smacked the top a few times, which broke the seal. Got a clean break, so we actually could put it back together if we needed to. You can see they don't look very healthy here, but I don't see anything yet as far as it being broken. Now that one there doesn't look like it's down all the way. I don't look flush like it should be. Not good. I gotta pop this one up yet. Take a look at the bottom side. This is kind of like your intake, or I should say it's your discharge, because you can see it comes out. This right here goes down into the discharge. Here's your suction side down on the bottom. So it's in its own little chamber here. Here's the top of the piston, sucks down. That's one piston, here's the other piston. Sucks down, pushes out here. Suck down, pushes up here. So that's your suction valves right there. That one goes up and down. That one does not, okay, that piston's probably already up. That one there goes to there. So you can see those kind of going up and down. That one there's kind of tight against it. Not real good here. Let's go ahead and pop this thing loose here, see if we can get a... It's on the edge corners. I don't want to bend up the metal. Maybe have to grab my chisel, but we'll break it loose. Okay, we're probably being a little dangerous here because one of those pistons probably could blow that thing off. I tapped it a second ago, powered it up. You can see she's got some compression. So she is going up and down some there. Not the greatest, but that should be sucking on your finger pretty strong. I don't know. I think our valves are definitely shot. I hate to knock that completely loose because I have a bad feeling I'm gonna break my seal, and I don't think I have any of these on my truck. That would be kind of nice if I did, but I don't. Pretty sure I don't. Now you can push down on it. So the valve looked like it's working. That one there is up now. These just look cruddy. But what I ended up doing, pulled a quick vac on it, opened that up. It still let the refrigerant back through. However, I did hit it and it did suck down, as you can see right there. Just tapped it and it did pulled it down to there, and it is kind of holding. So I mean, it's not completely garbage yet. I just am not happy with where we're at with it. So we're going to clean up some of these little potential rub through leaks here that we've got. And she knows that she needs to get this thing replaced as soon as possible, because this is just living on a prayer if we can even get it going. I'm going to slowly open up that suction. Man, that's just asking for leaks. What a disaster in a box. It's a disaster in a box. So as soon as I open this up, it will start to raise up and the suction pressure will come up and it will start to run. And we will just throttle it until it can handle it. Basically right now we're EPRing it, that's what we're doing. She's handling it. We're not getting that. Ew. Alright, start cranking it back in. Notice that? She seems like she's starting to shake a little funny. Valving this thing back down. I've never seen them do what it's doing. Kind of like a little car engine going on. You can't see it, but it's... I want to see what my discharge is doing. So this is R22, if I remember correctly, from what the guy told me that usually takes care of it. Hence the reason why it's green there. You can see the... We have a decent differential between the high side and the low side there. I still haven't opened that suction all the way yet, which is kind of scary. I'd like to just pump the sucker all the way down and make it start over. I think everybody's leaving, so they're just leaving me here alone. I actually got a bypassable stem there. I think we're just gonna... We're not looking too horrible. I mean, other than the glass looking horrible. Of course, I'm starving it because we're not letting it pull back. This thing should be about ready to handle the good times here. There, the suction's going down. Whoops, wrong direction. Back is tough puppy out. It's gonna run, especially as warm as it is, somewhere in that 20 degree range. Doing a little shaky dance down there. I don't know if you can pick it up. It don't look like it's picking it up on the monitor here, but I think we got it. Fan cycle control should be shutting off because we're below 90, we're at 85. But let's see what we've got. The sight glass is full, which it kind of looks like it is. Let's give it a little bit here. I think we might have it going good enough for to get them by until we get the replacement in here, which who knows if that crap's in stock. What's our coil look like here? All it blows from the rear forward. Nice. Blows away from it. I mean, figure all the dirt be on that side. Unless I'm leaking through. It feels pretty strong there, but yeah. It's blowing. How the heck is it dirty that direction? I wonder if that thing's wired wrong. Let's see if we can adjust that fan cycle. That is your low. This should be your fan cycle here. Hard to see what the heck's going on. Let's adjust our differential here. This should make it go down, and this here, it should make it shut off. There, finally. Make sure the fan's going the right direction too. It does not look like it's going the right direction. It's not. It should be going the other direction. See how it's backhanding the fan blades? It's not even right. So either it's wired wrong. Faster, usually what happens, it gets wired wrong. Let's see what we get up here. Temperature's about 110. About 110 area came on. That ain't bad. See what it does here in a minute. See if we can shut it off around 90. That's usually where I like to kill it at. Most things are based at 100 degrees. I've always noticed on the charts that my feeling is I don't want to go too crazy low. You don't want a big swing. Get too much of a swing, then the TXV starts hunting around. Now look at it. The fan's actually going the right direction. That's some wild stuff. Yeah, the fan motor's going out. See it? Now it's going the right direction. Now it's blowing back towards us. Might have a capacitor bad on him. Need to check that. There, just went the wrong direction. Yeah, we're going to shut it down, check a capacitor. Just what we need is a motor to go out. And unfortunately, you can't just wire it to run nonstop because you need the fan cycling, especially with as cold as it's getting. That's one of those never-ending stories, man. It just keeps on giving. So I went ahead and pumped it down. We're gonna see if this thing will pump down here. Unfortunately, everyone's left. This place is completely deserted. And I'm out here by myself in the middle of freaking nowhere. Yep, store is completely closed. Nobody here. Somebody could come in here, chop my head off, and you wouldn't even know it. All right, look at it. Just pumped down. Kick back on. Oh yeah, that's gonna take the capacitor out. Yeah, there, got it. All right, well, it gets it eventually. Yep, low pressure cutout's got some issues, but at least it'll pump down because that solenoid's out here. That differential on the low pressure probably could use a little adjustment too. We have jack on the 7.5 farad capacitor, so we may get lucky here. Got that capacitor in there. I did not put the cap on it because it was not wanting to fit, which will be fine. I am not worried about it. Let's go ahead and make sure this thing comes on at about the 20-ish mark, 22 pounds. There goes the refrigerant through. Solenoid's not energizing because it's not powered on. That would make a difference. Click. Up comes the pressure, about 22-ish. Good. On it comes. She handled that pretty good. Make sure that freaking fan comes the right direction here. That fan was hotter than heck too, go figure, right? Capacitor does phase shift, which is how it gets the rotation going on to a point. So let's see what happens here. Should start going clockwise rotation. About now, there it goes, boom. Look at that, now we're moving some air. Holy crap, huge difference. Now it's probably gonna be even lower on refrigerant. Valve here was leaking when I had a pump down also, so we need to seat that. No packing nut to tighten on it. We got the old Green Goblin hooked up. She's cycling pretty doggone decent for what we've got. We'll dump a little in here so we can get us a full sight glass.
I have to keep my flashlight to the edge corner there so I can kind of see past all the gunk that's on that sight glass. You could always pump it down, take it out, and clean that glass from the back side. And just, I don't see a point of spending a bunch of time on it. We're at 3 pounds here in a second. We're just about getting there. 3.5. The pressure's staying up. Okay, at that point, I'll sit there and just add a little bit past that. Just a couple dollars worth of Green Goblin. Just a couple dollars. Just about where it should be shutting off, too. It's just about there. I'll go to about 4.5 here, see how that does. Those are some big old monster tubes for receivers. All right, let's chop it there and see what we get. See if it holds steady without tripping out. Bubble galore here. I didn't anticipate this call going as long as it is. I mean, we've got a bad capacitor on the fan. Fan's going the wrong direction. That could have caused some major issues with the compressor. Had a bad start capacitor. I think it's a casualty of war here from the fan not kicking on like it's supposed to. Add that with the fan cycle there that's not shutting off as often as it should be. I got my differential turned down about as good as I could get it. I think I might need to raise my cut in a little higher to make up for the remainder. But it appears we're holding steady there on the glass. There, she shut right off at 90. I like that a little better. I sprayed my head down. We've got possibly a little bubble leach there. May have just been from the shaking. Yeah, I don't think we got any issues. I think it was from just shaking back and forth. This taken apart before. No major issues. There we go. 110 on. I'm okay with that. No change in the bubble situation there. Guys, I think we about got it. Gotta go inside the building and lock it. We got the doghouse on. Let's go back behind here where these fields are at. Woods, actually. Yeah, here we go. Let's go back behind here and make sure this place is locked up. Oh, yeah. It's getting warmer. Yeah, it's getting cold, dude. Getting cold. There's that one. And that one must blow. Yeah, it blows out the side. It's cold. You got 3 evaporators on this thing. Yeah, it's cold too. All right, good deal. It's working. Everything's closed up. Front door's hopefully locked. Let's make sure. Last thing I want is blame for anything. Guess we can get out of here now. Lock this door up. There we go. Give us the old lockeroo. There we go. Okay. Well, guys, I think we can call this a day. It's been great. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, don't let me down. Give me a big thumb. Prefer the thumb over the finger. Subscribe. And until next time, guys, we'll catch you on the next one. Have a good night. Later.